السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد. Distinguished dignitaries, my dear colleagues and companions. In this joyous occasion, I am with immense pleasure to make comments on the topic creative resistance in fascist era. First of all, I'm going to quote a line from a Facebook post of Deepak Shankar Narayanan. It is also a quote by the strategical words of a Chinese philosopher, Tui Tao. He says that, "Hence that general is skillful in attack whose opponent does not know what to defend. And he is skillful in defense whose opponent does not know what to attack." These lines show the need for the creative resistance in this fascist era. The military or the general will be skillful in attack whose opponent doesn't know to defend. And he is skillful in defense if his opponent doesn't know to attack. So, in this Indian scenario, it is not possible for an attack. The resistance is the only way out. While fascism is aggregating to its peak in India, the resistance is the only way out. The farmer protest is the best example that created a resistance wall which led to the government, or the fascist government, to move back. So if we keep mum, it may lead to a future disaster. So how we can creatively resist this fascist ideologies or these fascist aggravations and innovations? First of all, we can check the creative way for a resistance starts from the media. What is the Muslim influence of media? We can see that Muslim influence of media is very weak, and their ownership is worse than this. These are not words of mine. It's the words of Naigar Abdullah in his book Indian Muslims and the Media. He says the Muslims in India, in the field of media, is very weak, and the part of ownership, they are worse than this. So, as a democratic country, fascism can take rest, but democracy can't take rest. So, we should have creative resistance. According to the Indian fascism is in many ways it is different from the classical fascism. The history of the classical fascism were of the military protests and military attacks, but in India it is not possible. So we need constant actions and programs that make the deep human relationships. Moreover, the give-take bond between the religious, the relatives and neighbors, there should be a clear form of a deep bond between everyone. Another form of resistance is the pluralism. Apart from the other pluralism, our pluralism must be one which is mixed with the blood and which is mixed with the bone marrows of every individual of the country. Such a pluralism can resist fascism. The another creative resistance is the campus empowerment. We know many of the resistances, protests, many of the laws have changed. They have moved back because of the creative resistance from the campus. The campuses must be alert. They have to seek, they have to capture every movement of fascism and creatively resist. Then the other form of resistance is the strong opposition parties. The strong, when we make the opposition parties strong, it can create a great wall against the fascism. Even in the Kerala or even in India, the Muslims, the votes of Muslims are scattered and diverse to many sects of the society, many sectors of society. So when the Modi government came in came into the rule in 2014, there were certain powers behind it. So these powers can only be resisted by the opposition unity. So I conclude here by saying that fascism can take us, but democracy can't. Thank you. Have a nice day. Assalamu alaikum.